And so we hope that you will enjoy and you will be able to celebrate along with us as we play Celebration. Whether you're ready or not, Christmas is coming.
Thank you.
the bleak midwinter, along with angels we have heard on high. We hope that you will enjoy it. It'll be a blessing to you. And for the offertory, we have a special piece here, our own from Calvary Baptist Church, Brooks Britt. We'll be playing the solo for A Trumpeter's Lullaby. Thank you. But it's entitled Christmas Eve in Sarajevo, 1224. And it's an exciting, wonderful piece of music, and we hope that you will enjoy it.
Thank you. You're a monster, Mr. Brick. Your heart's an empty hole. Your heart is full of spiders. You have garlic in your soul, Mr. Bridge. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a foul one, Mr. Bridge. You have termites. Your smile, you have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Bridge. Give the choice between you, I take the seasick crocodile. What are you doing? What are you doing? You're a rotter, Mr. Bridge. Get out of here. You're the king of sinful sots. Your heart's a big tomato splotch with moldy purple spots, Mr. Bridge. Your soul is an appalling dump heap overflowing with the most disgraceful assortment of rubbish imaginable, mangled up and tangled up knots. You're a wild one, Mr. Bridge. You're a nasty, wasty stock. Your heart is full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Bridge. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote: stink, stank, stop. Get away from there.
It's a marshmallow world in the winter. Some people enjoy the winter and all of those ways. It's a marshmallow world in the winter. When the snow comes to cover the ground, it's the time to play. It's the wintering day. I wait for it the whole year. Frost creeping at your nose.
that time of year when we think about other visitors that come tonight. The story written by a pastor a long time ago, wrote it for his children, and it got around to others. And it goes like this. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas
would be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads, and Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap. Had just settled down for a long winter's nap, when, out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. And what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew it in a moment, it must be
reindeer.
More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled, and he shouted, and he called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder und Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all, as dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle and mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkle I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. Lots of hooves. And as I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. Oh, he was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung. Where'd you get that BMI bag, Santa? A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as a stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his, the smoke it encircled his head. But Santa has, as you know, Santa has since discovered that the U.S. Surgeon General knows that smoking is bad for your health, and so he no longer smokes the pipe. Yeah. He had a broad face and a little brown, round belly that shook when he laughed like a yes, he was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. But a wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but he went straight to his work. I wonder what Harold is getting. Check that thing out in the morning. You never know what he's gonna bring. All kinds of stuff in the sack. Yeah. Now, as I say, he spoke not a word, but he went straight to his work. And he filled all the stockings, and then he turned with a jerk. And yes, he did. And laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rode.
Our
horizontal chimney.
That'll do. Yeah, that's not as good as the girl's whistle. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team, gave a whistle. And away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, as he's getting ready, I heard him exclaim, as he drove out of sight,
"Happy